Today, I'll be making a loose generalization, but I hope it's useful as a rule of thumb for people who want to build with biology. Biological change usually looks like multiplication rather than addition. This is not a law of biology. Biology doesn't really do laws, but I use it anyway when I'm scoping out a new biological system and I wonder how much can I change this system with engineering. Let's do a concrete example. Let's say I'm a tomato breeder. I just crossed two varieties to make a new breed. So I grab some tomatoes and I weigh them. 1 ounce, 2 ounces. How big do I expect the biggest tomatoes to be? I'll make my guess by extrapolating from the little data that I have. If I assume that 1 and 2 ounce tomatoes are typical, I'd expect to see bigger tomatoes sometimes and much bigger tomatoes rarely. But how should I extrapolate? Do I think that tomato variation looks like addition? 1, 2, 3, 4? Or do I think it looks like multiplication? 1, 2, 4, 8? If I'm dreaming of the world's biggest tomato, and I am all the time, this choice determines how big I let myself dream. Now, there's no doubt we're making extremely rough guesses here. If you happen to be an expert in tomato breeding, you can do better than this. But sometimes you need to make a quick judgment call. And when you do, biological change probably looks like multiplication. In mathematical terms, we say that biological variation often follows a lognormal distribution. You're probably familiar with the normal distribution. It's the classic bell curve. Normal distributions are what tends to happen when you take a bunch of small random effects and add them up. Lognormal distributions are what happens when you multiply them. One characteristic of a lognormal distribution is a long tail at the high end. When many small effects line up in the same direction, multiplication pushes them further than addition would. Once you start seeing the long tail in biological data, you can't unsee it. It shows up everywhere. Take honey, for example. Honey naturally contains a molecule called hydroxymethyl furfural, or HMF. It's used as a marker for honey freshness. The concentration of HMF in honey follows a lognormal distribution, 10, 20, 40 milligrams per kilogram. Why? I have no goddamn idea, except that it's probably the result of many random effects that multiply. In the medical field, we see lognormal distributions in disease progression. Here's the incubation time for strep throat, the number of days between exposure to a pathogen and the onset of symptoms. Here's the incubation time for bladder cancer, the number of years following exposure to a carcinogen. Two completely different diseases, incubation in days or in years, but the same long tail. One more example. Let's zoom in to a single bacterial cell and ask how many copies we can find of a particular protein. Depending on the individual cell you're looking at, you might find 10, 100, 1,000, or more floating around. If you're used to thinking of additive variation and normal distributions, that range might surprise you. These are the core functional components of a cell, and they're fluctuating by factors of 100 as madness. But once you've opened your eyes to the lognormal in biology, it doesn't look strange at all. Why does biological variation look like this? I can think of two reasons. The first is pretty simple: exponential growth. Every time a population of cells completes a cell cycle, it doubles. 2, 4, 8. So small changes in the generation time can result in exponential changes in the total number of cells. The other reason has to do with the physics of binding. Most of what happens inside a cell is the result of proteins floating around and sticking to each other. Mutations in a protein sequence will change the free energy of binding, which, roughly speaking, has the effect of multiplying the number of proteins that end up bound. When you combine together many genetic changes, many multiplications, the result looks like a lognormal distribution, more or less, most of the time. To all the biophysicists out there watching, I hope you can forgive me. I'm probably generalizing more than most scientists are comfortable with, but that's kind of the point. I'm not saying that all biological variation is lognormal. It isn't. I'm not saying every biological system can be improved by a factor of 1,000. It can't. But what I am saying is that the log normal distribution is worth looking out for. Add the long tail to your mental model of biology, and your intuitions will be a little better on average.